Welcome to Drawfee Beans, where we take dumb ideas
and make even dumber drawings.
I'm Nathan.
I'm 1,000 Jacobs.
Whoa.
I'm just one Jacob.
Whoa.
I'm just one Karina.
Whoa.
I'm special anniversary Julia.
Whoa.
Because it's the 1,000th episode.
That's the rarest Julia of them all.
Wow. Whoa.
This is the 1,000th video we've uploaded to YouTube.
That's insane.
That's crazy.
Can we just think about how many videos 1,000 videos is?
That's a lot.
It's a bit much.
It's a bit much. You could watch one every day for 3 years almost.
And you know, granted, some of those are trailers for stuff we have coming out. Some of those are like announcements about the channel, but it's 1,000.
Yeah.
It's an arbitrary demarcation that we're celebrating here. And what we thought would be fun to do is do a little poo-poo platter of suggestions.
Don't say poo-poo platter.
Why didn't you say that?
a little fun, little mix 'em up, fun platter of suggestions that we don't think necessarily make sense to do full episodes of, but we see them a lot and we appreciate the people who are so consistent in watching our videos and leaving these suggestions. So this one's for you guys.
These ones been around.
These ones
been
around.
Your persistence is finally being awarded.
It's kind of.
Kind of.
Sort of.
Awarded, rewarded, whatever.
You're going to get a little bit.
Poo-poo platter.
You're going to get a bit of poo-poo platter on this one.
That's a word, poo-poo platter. It's like a little sample.
No, I know. Nathan, we got to tell you what you're doing.
Yeah, tell me what I'm doing.
Who's supposed to tell you what you're doing? Does it matter at this point?
No.
We all know what you're doing.
Yeah,
we
planned this ahead of time.
Okay, so
you're doing busty crustacean ladies.
Okay.
This one has been around for as long as I can remember.
Yeah.
Since time immemorial.
Yes.
And we just couldn't bring ourselves to do a whole episode of like crabs with boobs.
But we could do one. I could do one. I'll do a busty crustacean lady.
Yeah.
How's that sound?
Yeah.
I think that's a fine deal.
I'll do one.
Yeah.
We'll do it once.
I'm interested to see what ratio you go to between crab and lady.
Me too. I'm sort of feeling this one out.
Because right now this is a crab.
This is a crab's face.
Yeah.
And
also where do the boobies go?
Yeah. So I think here's what I'm thinking. Crab face. But then like a lady's body.
All right. Of.
And she's gotta be busty.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
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 So.
Wow, big old
mockers
on that one.
That's, I mean, busty.
That's busty.
She's at the beach.
No one can say this is not a busty crustacean lady.
But I do think still like crab arms.
Crab appendages,
Yeah. Little crustacean vibe to the whole thing.
Yeah.
This would be like a fantasy race in an RPG. Where they feel like, we want to make crab people, but we also have to put titties on it, unfortunately.
Like, but we love titties.
Yeah.
The one for male would just be a straight up lobster, and the one for female would be a lady with a crab head.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a really good crab claw.
Yeah,
that
really.
That is a good crab claw.
Thank you.
Look at you. You've been practicing your crab claws?
Always. I've been waiting for this. Guys, I have a confession to make. Busty crustacean ladies, that was my suggestion all along.
What?
No, it wasn't. I would never.
This is probably a good time to mention that we don't have the names of the people who suggested these. We tried to look, and they're like in so many videos,
right?
But it's impossible to
find.
You
can never find the suggestion you want when you need it.
Yeah, but you know who you are.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I hope that
And I'm sure a lot of other commenters know who you are, too.
Yeah. Everybody knows who you are, so we don't have to say it.
Because we see you.
We see
so
you.
So everyone sees
your,
you.
Your suggestion speaks louder than your name,
yeah,
it turns out.
Yeah.
You
should change your name to Busty Crustacean Ladies. And then you'll be living your truest life. I can't tell if she's threatening me.
I think she's going like, hey, girl.
But it's kind of threatening, too, because of the big claws.
Right, sure. But I think she's just going, hey, girl.
Okay.
Maybe like polka dots.
Yeah, like polka dots.
Yeah, maybe it's one of these ones that has, yeah. Got a little like this. There you go. I haven't given her like a face.
No, gave her eyes and a head.
What a crab face. What's a crab face?
Don't they have, I don't know.
They have like these things.
Yeah, like a little.
Yeah, that sound is correct. They do have those.
You know.
Because they like squirt bubbles out of them.
Right. Yeah. Sort of like.
They're real just like nasty.
Yeah.
Nasty little ocean
Your
bugs.
Your ability to like remember details about crabs is kind of blowing my mind.
Yeah. As per usual, Nathan's memory is just...
I know about animals.
Yeah, but anytime you gotta draw something from memory, you just nail it every time.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, it's
impressive.
You've
got an iron memory there.
I appreciate that. Because
I couldn't have done this one.
No.
I would have just drawn like a hamburger, because when I think of a crab, they're kind of like little sea hamburgers.
Yeah.
And then it would have just had some boobs like taped on. There somewhere. Oh, I didn't think.
Nice.
I don't think I wanted the lower half to be like this.
This Why is not? Giving me some Mars Attacks vibes now.
It's like really the only human element here is the torso.
This does look like very like B horror movie.
Yeah, absolutely. Like,
from the 80s.
Yeah. Attack of the booby crabs from outer space.
Whoa.
This lady and this crab got stuck in a body swapper together. Then they just got mixed up.
This is like an alternate history, The Fly.
And the crab.
It's called The Crab.
And it's, instead of Jeff Goldblum, it's Scarlett Johansson.
It's Scarlett Johansson.
That's basically the plot of the movie Under the Skin. Except instead of a crab, it's just a weird water room that sucks the guys in and squishes them.
Yeah, that'll happen. You gotta watch out for that.
You gotta watch out for that.
One of the producers is here, so if you hear a little meow on the... in the video, that's going to be her.
Yeah.
She's decided that now is the time she requires to be petted.
Well, she wants to make sure this isn't the whole episode.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's like, are you sure?
She saw the screen and was like, guys, I don't know about this one.
She has a note for Nathan.
Yeah.
Specifically, she's on Nathan's chair. Hello. She's like, you have to stop.
It's like, I think you've taken enough time with this crab woman.
You're really lovingly rendering it.
And
there's more.
I've got to do the classic joke.
Mm-hmm.
The little classic joke. Because she's a busty crustacean and she's at a crusty bus station.
Oh my god.
So there's a little bus schedule.
And it's crusty.
And it's pretty crusty.
I never want to be in swimwear at a bus station.
No, that's a bad way to be.
This made me sad.
Yeah.
I usually don't want to be at a bus station, period. Yeah. But
now I feel like she was at the beach and then there was an emergency and she had to like...
No, she had a good day at the beach and now she's just coming home.
She's partaking in public transportation. She's trying to cut down on greenhouse gases.
Yeah, give her her like beach bag.
She should put a shirt on before she gets on the bus. Just like for hygienic reasons.
But she's wet. She's all wet.
She should be dry before she gets on the bus.
First, get it together.
Yeah.
At a time when everyone needs to wash their hands. Oh.
One of the producers is...
The producer is not having this. She is on the desk.
She's okay. Left onto the desk.
On the desk.
Oh my God, is she going to unplug stuff?
No. She goes back there all the time.
She's shutting it down. The whole thing is done.
Olive.
Do you have anything to say to the people that you want them to know?
This bus station is on the beach.
The bus just crashes into the sand.
Yeah. I hope this is what you wanted, because this is the only time we'll ever do this.
And here it is.
Jacob.
Yeah.
It's you.
Okay, let's switch seats.
Olive has moved to the other desk because she sees that this drawing is over.
Yeah, she's content.
Thank you, Olive, for your notes.
Her work
here is done.
Okay. Which thing am I doing? Which suggesto?
You are going to do Florida Man headlines.
Oh, this one's been around for so long.
Yes.
Yeah.
And we haven't done it because we didn't want to be offensive.
There's a lot going on with the Florida Man stuff. Has to do with sort of public records laws and, you know, criminal justice is a whole thing.
And we get all that. And so instead we're doing a generator that makes one up.
Yeah, we're just going to do one.
And it's going to be a funny one that it hasn't happened to a real person.
Yeah. I mean, it might have, but
it's pulled from different ones.
Yeah.
It's pulled from a random generator.
Give it to me. I must draw.
Okay. Jacob, your randomly generated headline is Florida Man Under Extreme Stress Forgets How to Stand.
Okay, so this Florida man doesn't know how to stand anymore because of how stressed he is.
Yes.
That ain't a mood.
Yeah, I do feel, I feel that. Okay, yeah, I can do that. I was born to do that. So I think we're going to go, I think right off the bat, head on the ground.
Yes.
If your head's on the ground, you're not standing.
You're not standing
right.
Correctly.
Yeah, this is not where that's supposed to be at all.
He's been head on the ground trying to find some busty crustacean ladies to look at
for
too long that he forgot how to even stand.
And I think he is strong.
Okay.
He's like a Muscle Beach, Florida guy.
Okay.
Do you ever go to Florida and people are just like really strong?
I go everywhere and everyone seems stronger than me, but I'm just very weak.
I'm sorry.
So...
Do you want to like go to the gym or something? We could take a class.
I got a ring fit.
You got a ring fit?
I got a ring fit.
Oh, that looks so fun. I was like tempted just because it looks like such a good time.
I've always wanted to work out, but I wanted my hair to be on fire also.
And that finally.
And now finally.
It can happen.
That was the main thing stopping me, was my hair not being on fire. As an indication of me doing a good job working out.
Totally. So Florida Man is stressed out.
That's great, Nathan.
I feel like I just had nothing else to contribute to
that. It went on for too long, that whole part.
And I'm really sort of focused up on Florida Man's plight.
And the nice thing is that you drew a really good, funny face, and now we can sort of focus on that and move on.
Yeah.
That is a stressed face.
Yeah, because like we need like sweat and
I'm
like sort of.
I'm familiar with that face.
he's like a little embarrassed that he can't remember how to stand up.
I know it was like something. Part of you goes on the ground. I know that.
Which part?
I know this isn't right, but am I close?
Yeah, but which part? And he's kind of got like you can tell that his hair was like looking nice, but now it's disheveled.
Mm-hmm.
Because of, you know, the stress.
Yeah. Again, mood.
Yeah. And so I think we all can relate to that a little bit.
Just a little.
And he's strong. So here's a shoulder. And I think this is going to be like an arm going this way. And then sort of like, this one's on the ground.
Oh, he's trying to do a little push.
For a split second, I thought you were going to make that his hand. He's going to have a little, like, baby arm.
No. I mean, his arm does look pretty short.
Compared to his head, but maybe...
No, I think this is right. He's at an angle.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then this one's, like...
He's got such strong shoulders.
Yeah, this one's going out, like, this way. Maybe, like, sort of backwards.
He's sort of grasping.
Yeah. We got some, like, foreshortening going on
I
here.
I like this. I like this a lot.
And so this one's out this... Going off. Stretching off this way. And then... this is kind of fun.
Yeah.
And then maybe his torso is like bent around.
Oh.
Kind of up here.
I am imagining that this is what busty crustacean is looking at on the other side of the street. This guy was trying to get to the bus stop.
It's the same beach.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is the same beach. And it's like, is he like a performer?
Yeah.
Like, what's he?
And she was like, I gotta go. This is a sign.
What's his angle here?
This is a sign that I have to go home.
There's a spine. You gotta identify where the spine is. That'll help you with that.
With the posing.
With the posing when you're posing a man who forgot how to stand.
He's so strong.
Yeah, he's really strong.
If he ever does get to stand, he'll be the most powerful man around, but he can't get there.
Yeah, he's forgotten completely.
So sad.
So I think, okay.
Yeah.
He's got incredible hip flexibility. Let's get that out of the way right now. Okay. His hip and his like
what am I looking at?
That's a
is
butt.
Is that butt? Well,
that's one half of
this
butt.
This is going to be a butt. And then one leg he's got kicking like this.
Wow.
So he does have one leg that's like sort of spine just reaching the ground.
Jelly.
This guy does yoga.
Yeah.
So this one's on the ground. So he kind of was almost getting there. Like he's figuring it out.
Okay. Yeah,
and this is like a good sort of downward dog.
He gets that the leg should be on the ground. It's just the rest of the body he hasn't oriented correctly yet.
Well, he's got this leg on the ground, but he's not like sure is the problem.
Okay, yeah.
And then I think the other leg, get the butt kind of around.
There are no handholds here for him to, it's a wide.
Let's get sort of like a butt.
Yeah, spread. Uh-huh. Spread the cheeks.
This one's gonna be going.
Oh,
I want it to be really.
Oh, that's a choice.
Around this way.
Yeah,
this man should join Cirque du Soleil.
Yeah.
So his butt's kind of like this.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Would be good.
Like, there's one cheek, and it's like turned. There's a turn to it, and then this one's coming like this. That's like a bulge.
Well, like
where his junk would be. And then here's, if you add pockets, you can really sort of like help identify for the viewer.
Oh, it's jorts.
Yeah, he's wearing jorts.
Okay, I thought maybe those were athletic shorts, but no, those are those
he
are
has
jorts.
Like multiple butt cheeks. Wait, I have to fix this. Here we go. Here we go. He's got a
fix this.
He's got a big old ass.
Yeah. Okay. So yeah, thank you.
So see now this,
now it makes
now
perfect
this
sense.
Makes perfect sense.
Uh-huh.
This one goes around like that.
Yep.
And then if we do like
this,
that I think is flawless,
mm-hmm.
frankly. And
curse this mess.
This leg.
Yeah, what are we doing?
How's he gonna do it? How's he gonna do it?
Straight out from there.
Curling like into a C shape.
I think it's going down.
What?
How?
That's not how knee do.
This leg isn't socketed.
Yeah, he fully dislocated that
loose.
One.
This one's a little bit
that
loose.
One's a little loose. He's got more issue. Once he figures out how to stand up, he's going to realize that he needs to go to a doctor.
Yeah, he's done a lot
immediate
wrong. This
pop
one's
it
like,
back into place.
Yeah, the toe is like pointed so he could have it kind of reach the ground
mm-hmm.
Over here.
Yeah. Sorry, bud. You're not.
I really want to do like a full turnaround of this pose.
It's. I don't think it's possible. I think I've created an impossible situation. But I, for one, believe that he's going to figure it out one of these days.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to figure out what the bone in the calf is doing. Well, not in the calf, the thigh.
This is the beach.
What, on
the left? He's also at the beach.
Yeah, he's at the beach.
He's going to miss the bus. Not...
You can't, if you stood up, that's facing backwards.
You can't. I got too stressed out, and now I can't stand up to get to the bus, which is stressing me out even more.
Yeah. Also, you're not going to get allowed on the bus if you're doing that.
And I mean, it's the 1,000th episode.
I mean, they might let you on.
I mean,
a frustration toot.
We're going to get a toot. I feel like I can't. It's perfectly posed.
It's lovely.
Wonderful.
You're just like so stressed, you just toot.
Yes.
That's what's happening to Florida Man here.
Very good.
Wonderful.
Okay. I'm
the
done.
Producer had nothing to say about this drawing.
No, she left, not present.
A plus work. Karina.
Here I come.
Here she comes.
Wow, what happened?
Was that your phone?
Nathan throwing his whole phone to the ground.
It came out of its case. Aww. But it's okay.
The case saved the day.
That's why you always get a case.
Karina.
It's been 1,000
Karina's suggestion that she's got
to
do is draw Hosier lyrics.
Wow.
Yeah. Do you want some lyrics?
I've chosen a lyric for you. And your lyric is, take me to church. Uh-huh. I'll worship like a dog at the shrine of your lies.
That's it.
If you guys know that Hosier lyric, it's the one everyone knows.
Whoa. I forgot that's how it goes. You just forget. You listen to Take Me to Church too many times and you just forget. So worship like a, take me to church. I'll worship like a dog at the shrine of your lies.
Of your lies.
Well, I'm just going to block in a shrine right here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll do it later, but for composition purposes, yeah. Know that the shrine of lies is right
of
there.
Of your lies.
Yeah. My lies.
I feel like we should stress that the reason we haven't done this is because none of us really know any Hosier lyrics
other than Karina.
I mean, I've listened to his album. I have it on my phone.
I said Hosier when I said it, and that's wrong based on how everyone else is saying it.
Oh well, yeah, it's like Hosier and hosiest.
It's not the hosiest.
It's an evolutionary line.
Hosier. Yeah. Am I saying that right? Hosier.
So
I think so.
Okay.
I'm not the expert, as I've stated.
I'm gonna look up a pronunciation guide.
Thank you.
Yeah, please do.
Guide for Hosier.
Hosier is another possible way. He's French.
What?
We've listened to Hosier, but Hosier. None of us are.
What genre of music is Hosier?
It's kind of like, it's a little bit
country, a little bit rock and roll.
It's not a little bit country. I would say it fits into sort of like that John Mayer-esque,
okay,
vaguely bluesy alt rock kind of thing, like part folk, part rock.
Julia's listening to the pronunciation guide. There's such a serene look on her face.
According to Hosier, it's Hosier.
Get out of here. It's okay. Hosier.
Hosier.
That's
It's not Hosier. It's Hosier.
It's Hosier.
He's a fancy man.
Yeah, he's fancier than I thought.
Is he wearing a little dog onesie?
Yeah.
Aww.
Worship like a dog.
Yeah.
Really get into the character.
Really get into.
Well, I guess your knees, the thing that dogs do, I guess, but that's why you're dressed up.
How do dogs worship? I've never seen a dog worship.
Like, they do that thing. You know, where they like do the tappies.
That's them worshiping.
Yeah. Oh,
okay.
They look up and they do the tappies and their tail wags.
Yeah, aww, they're just buddy. Like,
shit, I want that Ritz cracker.
That dip.
They just like, you know, like the worship enters their body and they go like tap, 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 tap.
That's cute stuff.
Yeah, it's real cute when dogs worship.
maybe all of these were good suggestions and we were
and
wrong.
We've
wasted them.
Yeah, we judge prematurely.
After 1,000 videos, we're just good at doing anything. We're just skilled at doing this exact set of things that we're doing.
I don't know who this person is, but do you think they're like embarrassed about this dog worship role play?
Not as embarrassed as the guy who couldn't stand.
They're just like,
yeah.
I guess.
But I kind of like it.
But I don't want to be weird about it.
I feel like I've opened the door and this guy's like, oh my God, I've been seen.
Okay, point of view. You walk in.
Yeah. To the shrine.
He's like looking at you.
Like, listen, I didn't think I was going to be here either, but life throws us different ways.
You said you would work till 7 tonight. Did that not? I asked you to text me when you were on your way home.
Some correct pelvis work.
I know this is a shared space, like, but you're usually not here and I clean it up. It's just that my room's not big enough to both have the shrine
yeah,
and also
to lie shrine.
And also to do the dog suppose I get it. You're upset. You're clearly upset. Can I just finish up though? Because I'm really close to done worshiping
the shrine of your lies.
Of your lies.
Yeah, you're the person. Is it his roommate?
POV roommate worships like a dog at the shrine of your lies.
Role play.
Role play.
ASMR. It'll be like one of those weird closet shrines, like in Hey Arnold.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
A little chewing gum statue.
Yeah.
Gross.
Well, POV you, so that's your face.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. I might have to make it a little indistinct, not because I want to hurry this up or anything, but because it's you, and you can just put your own face there.
Yeah, paste your own face over the top, and it becomes the shrine of your lies.
Yeah.
I guess the you being home later... That turned out to be a lie. So that's that's gonna have to go in the shrine now.
What is this?
It's the shrine of your
it's
lies.
It's a shrine of your lies.
It's a shrine of your lies. Whatever. This looks like a It's a little.
Have you never made a shrine of lies before? Because you're acting like you've never seen one.
You're right. You've caught me. I've never made a shrine of your lies.
Is this your display case for conventions?
I don't know what this is. I think I was going for like a bookshelf looking thing, but
it kind of looks like a tiny IHOP.
It does.
Here, now it's just a plank of wood. He nailed it to a cardboard box. He is a mess.
Upside down cardboard box. Nailed between two planks of wood.
With just like a mannequin head on it.
Yeah, but it's you. It's you. You.
This is you.
You listening right now.
Yeah.
This is you. Just put your face here. It's you. here are some of your lies. Like, you printed them out. Yeah. You, like, made copies. You, like, took photos. This guy is weird.
Just, like, Instagram
posts. This is, like, a horror story.
Yeah. But he's so cute.
It's like some, I don't know. That's just trash.
How can you stay mad at that face?
He's still doing the tappies and the waggies, even though you've come in.
Like, you walk in, and he has not stopped.
But yeah, if you're doing anything in a shared space, you should make sure that it's cool with your roommates before you do it. Don't
if you make a shrine of their lies,
keep the private stuff
worship
to your
it in a dog
room.
Suit. Like,
yeah,
just you know.
Do it in your own room.
Don't do it like somewhere where they'll see it.
Yeah.
This is the Journal of Lies where he documents every lie that you've told.
Your room has a lock and you use it.
I don't know. He's just what is this?
It's two planks of wood with a cardboard box
what it is.
Nailed to them.
Yeah, it's a perfect
Here's a
shrine.
Bouquet. Oh.
So many questions.
It's like some Christmas lights hanging off of it.
Yeah, maybe like
right on a budget.
One scented candle.
Yeah.
Okay. It's balanced a bit precariously.
See, now this is a fire safety issue.
Yeah, this is why you're mad.
This went from just being weird to being an actual safety
problem. You shouldn't balance that on a plank of wood.
No.
That's weird. And that's right next to the Christmas lights? Stop it. Get a hold of yourself.
Right now this is just a cord. It's an extension cord. Okay, yep, got to get the outlet. Make sure it makes
that's
sense.
That's important. And I got to actually draw the lights. And Hosier, deep stuff.
Yeah.
Got a lot going on there.
I guess I've
got
to listen to them.
I think it's really just him.
This is Hosier.
This is Hosier.
Sorry, Hosier. Please don't break into my home.
Just make a shrine of Karina's lies. Yeah.
My favorite Hozier song is like Real People Do.
This box is floating and I don't care
anymore.
It's nailed. It's nailed to the wood.
There's more journals of your lies that Hozier kept for you under the box, which is floating, and I give up.
It makes sense.
It's a bean, so you don't have to render this, so it's fine.
Please don't steal me away to your forest cave, Hozier. Whatever it is that you do.
Amazing job.
Very good.
Me.
Julia.
It's time for you to get your comeuppance.
Yeah.
You've sat in the back long enough.
I did.
Watching us suffer.
Yeah. Now it's my turn. I'm drawing a suggestion that's been around for just so long.
Well, we have to tell you what it is.
Yeah.
You're breaking format.
Well, no one was doing it, and there was quiet, and we get anxious if there's quietness on this show, so I was filling it.
Julia's drawing propaganda for the Great Emu War.
Yes.
Yes.
And like she said, this one's been around. A tale as old as time.
Yeah.
Which, again, the fact that all these suggestions have been around for so long indicates that the people making these suggestions have watched so many of our videos. So once again, thank you for watching.
That's a big thanks to you.
Yeah.
Friends. You're the ones who have kept us vaguely employed.
Yeah.
Dubiously employed.
Employed.
Yeah.
In air quotes.
Yeah. So what's your thinking about for this, Julia? What's your angle?
Angle right now is trying to know how to draw these weird dinosaurs that are emus.
Yes.
Just draw a weird dinosaur.
For anyone who's unfamiliar, I was unfamiliar until I finally looked this suggestion up. The Great Emu War is a real thing that happened in Australia, where they sent the army to go try and get rid of some emus, and it didn't work.
The emu said, no thank you.
That's the TLDR version. There's a lot more to it, or maybe not. I don't claim to be an Australia historian.
Yeah.
But
this is real and it happened.
This is real and it happened. The army went to go fight some emus and the emus won. Which truly is a beautiful story.
Do we think the emus had
tale as old as time.
Weapons?
Emus are weapons.
They are weapons, but did they have weapons?
Someone's playing basketball right up next to.
Yeah, we have a neighbor kid who just loves to play basketball the second he gets home from school.
We've unfortunately got a grade A b-ball kid living right outside.
Good for him.
And he just likes to go out there and dribble the day away.
Yeah.
I mean, he's probably better at dribbling than I am.
He's definitely better at dribbling than any of us are, because he's out there working on it day in, day out.
Meanwhile, we're doing this.
We're doing this.
Yeah. You know, we each have our own crafts that we've been perfecting over a lifetime.
We're probably better at this than he is.
Yeah, I'd like to see him draw some propaganda.
Can we like invite him up here
for the Great
Emu War? Owned.
Yeah, he like draw something beautiful in like 5 minutes flat and like really just raises the banter to a whole new level.
Yeah. Wow, he made... I learned something.
Yeah, I feel like I learned something. I laughed, and I've grown as a person.
I've grown as a person.
And physically by 2 inches.
Wow, he did another history as anime before we did.
We're going to do another one of those.
We've got so many ideas for videos that we want to do once...
One for a channel again?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, we're a channel, but... You know, there's stuff.
We're stuck,
we have to work out.
We're in the muck and the mire right now.
Yeah.
And we need to crawl out and ascend to the heavens where we belong.
Is this an emu?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay.
They got a big bean bod.
Unmistakable.
And a stupid long neck. Emus are dumb.
They are pretty dumb looking, but they did defeat an entire army.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So there's that at
Jacob,
least.
Jacob, are you trying to go to war with the emus?
Maybe I am. Maybe I'll finish what the Australians couldn't.
Here he goes again.
Do you guys want to know my emu anecdote?
Yes. I can't believe you have one, but
absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
When I was in middle school, me and my friend made up a game called Emu Hunter that we would play during class. And the way you played was you would draw an emu on a piece of paper, and then you put that piece of paper on the floor, and then you would try to drop your pencil and like hit the emu from your desk.
Sounds like a nightmare for your teacher.
Yeah, really.
Well, we did it because it could be played kind of discreetly. You know? And
your teacher definitely knew what was happening.
So, yeah, yeah, discreetly, like, from your
these
perspective.
These little idiots dropping things.
Knew we were playing Emu Hunter, and they didn't want to get in the way of that. And then you'd make the emus like harder and harder to hit, like as you escalated.
Oh, you'd draw smaller and smaller.
Smaller and in like crazy poses. And, you know, give it a try. If you're in school.
Different parts of the emu worth more points.
Yeah, there was definitely points because you wanted to get the, you know, the head. That's a full hunt right there. But if you hit like a leg, then
no, the
that's
emu,
not going to do the job.
Yeah, it's not going to do as strong of a kick.
That won't stop an emu.
That yeah. won't stop an emu. But yeah, if you're in school, this is what I'm saying to every student watching this.
Yeah.
Start playing Emu Hunter during your classes while your teacher is teaching.
Yeah, now you can even record it as you do it because of technology.
Yeah, you can make it a TikTok.
Yeah, and then go viral. Make Emu Hunter go viral.
And then you'll be a TikTok influencer, and yeah. I will have decided your whole career path.
And your teachers, who are probably people like our age, will just be so unhappy with us.
Yeah. Yeah, I was just thinking that I can't wait, like, if this does actually take off, for just the text chain between my parents and my brother to
oh yeah
like,
you've got teachers in your family.
Yeah, what the hell is the source of this stupid emu war, them for to look it up and to see that it's this program.
It's Emu Hunter.
It's Emu Hunter.
Emu Hunter.
Emu, yeah. Emu War is what you're
emu
drawing.
Yeah. Yeah,
Emu
sorry.
Hunter.
I'm on
the
task here.
Yeah,
but I was just thinking, looking at your drawing, that this would make already for a good game of Emu Hunter. Put this drawing on the floor, drop a pencil on it, try to get that emu.
Emu, your emu anecdote, Jacob, reminded me that in middle school, my friends and I just thought emu was a funny word to say.
Oh, everyone did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was sort of the extent of our sense of humor.
Yeah.
It was just picking a word and deciding this is the funny word now, and we'll just repeat it a lot.
Yeah.
Which I guess hasn't evolved too much.
No.
No, no. That's going to happen forever and with every generation, that they pick a funny word.
And to us.
And to us. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But we had the TI-83 calculators.
Oh, hell yeah.
And so you could write little programs for them. And so one of the ones we would do is just the one where it would just be repeating. You can make the parentheses repeat, and they do a little dance.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And it just destroys the battery because it just runs forever. But one of our friends made the indestructible emu program where, because if you press the on button, it stopped the repeating parentheses.
Right.
But I don't know what the programming this kid did, mm-hmm. but it just, the word emu would just be on screen, and then there was nothing you could do to get rid of it. You couldn't turn the calculator off. You couldn't do any math with it. So he would just take your calculator and put the indestructible emu on
it. He just bricks your calculator?
Yeah. Yeah. You had to take the batteries out in order to,
okay.
Wow.
In order to get
what a
it
move.
To stop.
I hope that kid is now an adult. who is like a programmer or something.
Yeah.
I hope he's a famous software person.
It was some good stuff. Definitely, I'm sure any of my teachers would be happy that the thing that I remember best from my schooling was the indestructible emu.
Yeah.
Everything else out the window.
Yeah, get rid of it.
I know that at least one person who watches Drawfee attends my old middle school and high school. Attended my old middle school, attends my old high school, something along those lines.
Really?
And one of my old middle school classmates is now a teacher at that middle school.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
So it could all come around.
It could all come around.
That person watching this video could start playing Emu Hunter.
Yeah. Oh.
At your old school. And your old middle school friend will have to deal with that. And it'll be my fault and your fault.
Yeah. More of an acquaintance than a friend, but.
No, well then.
Damn.
Wow, demoted on the program.
And who cares?
Their legs bend backwards, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
It's the ankle. It's just because they got high ankle.
Are they motoring across the ground like
they're
Gundams
running.
Do?
They're speedy boys.
Yeah.
Their legs do not indicate.
They're at war.
A run. It indicates that they're like, they've crouched down and just like gone.
I just threw one leg and I was like, oh, right. They bend backwards. I don't know how that looks when it runs. I'm just going to draw them all at a right angle.
Yeah, they're just doing the little thing. It's like a little video game. It's like Joust.
Yeah, yeah. They're doing just like the little tappies. Like,
yeah.
I know we don't normally render our beans drawings.
And yet.
But I would love to see a rendered version of this at some point.
I was about to say, this is kind of already
it's already
rendered.
This is so good. I'm glad I didn't have to do this.
Yeah, I'm glad that you're doing this and not me, for sure.
I would just draw a billion emus, but...
Yeah, I would not have gone this route, definitely.
I'm trying to speed it up as much as possible, because I also want to get, like, a slogan in here.
Oh, yeah.
What would the slogan be?
I feel like it's something stupid, like, together we can fly or something.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Because emus don't. Right?
Yeah, individually, they cannot, but together.
Okay.
Can I say something important?
Yeah.
If you look down at the bottom left corner, those two emus, it kind of looks like a butt with two little legs.
Oh, yeah.
Like a little man.
Yeah,
just
that's just like
out.
Someone who fell
that's
down
little,
in the foreground.
Our little Florida man still trying to stand up.
There you go. There's a little
shit
there.
He's trying to get out of the photo.
Doing little kickies.
But couldn't make it out in time. It's like, oh, dang. Oh.
That was very important, Jacob. I'm glad you said it.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. I mean, thank you for drawing it, because it made me happy to look at.
You're welcome. Anything I can do. All right.
Together we can fly?
Yeah. I feel like it's also got to be like...
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, get some good...
You know.
Little cursive-y.
Damn.
I can't tell where the top of the screen is anymore.
Yeah, you did kind of...
I've done goofed myself.
A self goof.
Okay.
Classic.
Two.
Frog. From Togepi. Together. You cross the H.
It's fancy script.
It's fancy.
Okay. Sorry, it's fancy script.
My God.
I'm sorry.
It's good. It's
That's
good.
How you know it's fancy.
I'm sorry.
It's because it's wrong.
Jacob.
I'm so sorry.
Anytime I try and write anything in real time on this program, it is a disaster. And so I'm always very impressed with good penmanship.
Here's my question about script. Mm-hmm. When you guys learn script, and you know the difference between like the N and the M is that there's like that extra bump, and the M has too many bumps.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Did you guys just skip that?
Because
like the R is like this, and
right.
Then when you're supposed to draw an N,
mm-hmm.
it like kind of looked like an M,
yeah.
And then when you draw the M, it was like... There's your M.
Yeah.
What do you mean skip it?
Everyone in my class just wrote an N, like, without that extra bump.
And M? Both?
How did they discern between the N's and the M's?
So the N, they would just, like, stop and then write an N, and then they would stop for the M and then just write an M.
Oh, I didn't do that.
It's
like,
weird
broke
that your whole class, like, decided mutually...
Because they couldn't, like, understand that there was, like, one little difference.
They're like, as a whole, we are going to come together and refuse.
Yeah.
I like together we...
together we... I'm going to have to move this. I'm going to have to move this because I don't have enough room.
What if it's just together we fly?
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, that could be good. I like that because I do want to keep that butt down there.
Okay. Yeah, do not get
that,
rid of the
that's
butt.
The top, right?
Yeah, and then you just put fly like right in that
a
little...
big fly. Yeah.
How should I do?
Yeah.
Well, I feel like it has to be like
Julia.
Well, it's usually like they do that in propaganda posters.
Yeah,
this is how they won.
Yeah.
This makes me feel motivated.
Yeah, I want to join the emus.
Yeah.
You ever just want to be an emu?
Not before, but not, now, yeah. Yes.
Now I'm considering.
For the first time ever, yeah. I consider.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Thank you to everyone for your persistence in suggesting. And may this episode serve as a beacon of hope to those of you who have suggested many times the same thing and have not seen it done yet.
Yeah.
We see you. We appreciate you. We love you.
And thanks to everyone who's watched all 1,000 videos that we've made. I know there are people that have done it.
Yeah.
Someone has definitely watched all 1,000.
And that is crazy to me, and I am immensely grateful.
Yeah, that person is not me.
Yeah, I don't admittedly watch any of our videos.
Yeah, that's also a fair choice to make.
I've watched most of them just out of necessity, right, from at least when we started editing. But there's a good chunk of them that Caldwell and I would just sort of grind out in the middle of the day and did no editing on. And those we just posted sight unseen. Just like whatever we said, that's going up.
It's there forever.
Yeah. So if you watched all those,
yeah,
thanks.
Comment down below with the exact number of videos you have watched.
Yeah, I want to see who's got the high score.
Yes. Exact.
We're going to make a leaderboard. It's going to become like sort of a multiplayer gaming experience.
Yeah, we want to gamify the Drawfee watching experience. It's not gamey enough.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like that
and
sweet.
And you guys will love it.
Sweet gamey emu meat.
Gamey emu meat.
I've never had emu meat.
Let's end.
Let's stop. Julia's just rendering.
Yeah.
Here's to another 1,000 episodes. Thank you all so much for watching, and we're very sorry.
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 Sorry times 1,000.
Wow.